Really yeah. interesting what coming down the pipe.
There's also, Willie, a strong message in Elizabeth Warren's campaign for the rest of the candidates in the field, and it is, she's talking about the future.
Yes.
There's a plan for the future, not where we've been, where we are going.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And here's the thing about her message. I mean, with Elizabeth Warren, first of all, she loves this. She loves doing the town halls. She loves the whole process. She really loves what she's doing. She's a really nice person on top of it, which helps. I'll also say that on the debate stage, the optics completely worked for her. She was in the middle of the stage. She owned her space. And some could argue she even looked presidential. It's her story. Her message is her story. She actually chose her education around her message, around her life story, around the issue of bankruptcy and the little guy getting screwed. And she delivers that message every day. And she cuts through things like, you know, we talked yesterday about those mobility numbers where people think we're doing perhaps better than they really are in terms of how well they're going to do in the future. People are listening to her message and they're doing the math. And then they're making donations.
You know,
and here you see these numbers.
One other thing, Mika, that's, I think, very important. People have already forgotten. A lot of people have already forgotten it. Donald Trump has already taken her on.
Yeah.
Donald Trump has already attacked her.
Donald
Trump has already ridiculed her, mocked her, and in fact was saying, maybe I attacked her too early because she's collapsed in the polls. No, she's already taken the hit head on from Donald Trump. And guess what? It had no impact on her. That's something that Donald Trump needs to be concerned about, because now she's immunized from those attacks.
Absolutely. Still ahead on Morning Joe, yesterday we learned that the British ambassador to the U.S. called the Trump White House inept and uniquely